With more than 40 years as one of the biggest Hollywood costume designers, she certainly has a lot of stories about stars, and she wrote the book to prove it. And joining us now is the talented, the amazing Diana Eden. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Thank you.
Okay. I wanted you to have the honor of giving us the title of your book. It just made me smile.
It's called Stars in Their Underwear.
And boy, you've seen plenty of those stars in their underwear. Tell us a little bit about your Vegas connection. It goes way back to the 70s.
It does. It does. I started coming up here a lot as a very young costume designer with Ann Margaret. And she had an enormous, fabulous nightclub act, which played usually at Caesars. And so I got to come up here and work with her and watch her perform every night and take care of the costumes.
And she was a lady in red. We're actually looking at some of your the images that you sent us, and I gasped. I'm like, that is stunning.
Yes, yes. Well, she's fabulous to design for, as well as being a wonderful human being. So it was a great way to start my career. And through her, I met other performers that I worked with. And I also met Bob Mackie, who invited me to be his assistant on the creation of Jubilee.
And those costumes, talk about mind-blowing and wow. I've seen some of those costumes up close and personal. They are stunning. Tell us about your time at Jubilee.
Well, it took about, let's see, 10 months that I was working on the show with Bob, and the costumes were all made in Los Angeles. I mean, they were huge. The feathers would arrive from Paris in these enormous crates, and the jewelry would arrive from Europe. And, you know, we'd open it, and it was like diamonds spilling out. And so 8 weeks before the opening, we came up to the MGM, now Bally's, we were doing fittings because every single costume had to be fit on the showgirls and the dancers.
Bob Mackie, of course, a legend. That show also now showgirls legends as well, as you are too. Let's talk a little bit about, in your book, you do mention one of the darkest periods here in our history, Las Vegas's history. You were actually there to experience it all.
Yes, yes. Yes, the morning of the fire, I was in my room asleep and heard strange noises out in the hallway. And it didn't sound like partygoers coming back from a party. It was something weird. So when I went out into the hallway, it was full of smoke and people were running and saying, don't go that way, it's too smoky. So I did manage to get to the fire escape and the fire stairs and walked down 11 stories in my bare feet. Wow. And it was a terrible experience.
Yeah. It's heartbreaking to see these images. We are glad that you made it out safely. Let's talk about, on a lighter note, you talk about that, but you also talk about, again, your experiences here in Las Vegas, but also in Hollywood. What else can we expect?
Well, lots of good stories of wonderful people that I worked with. Betty White is one of them. I worked with her. Yes, she is just everything you hope she'd be. Funny and kind and smart as a whip. So there's a couple of Betty White stories in there. Tony Danza, I worked with on several different shows. So we got some stories in there. Deborah Messing and Thomas Hayden Church. Just lots of really wonderful experiences designing costumes for TV series.
Oh, I cannot wait. I hope someday you're able to come here in our studio. I would love to do a more in-depth interview with you. You have so many wonderful stories to tell. How can we get your book?
On Amazon, Amazon.com. Oh. Look for Stars in Their Underwear. There's only one book with that title.
I love that title. Thanks again for joining us. You have a wonderful day.
Thank you so much. All right. Thank you.